linear regression is used to study the linear association between one or more independent variables and a continuous dependent variable. I'm Mohammad Sahebhonar, and in this demo, I want to use Visual Studio Code to perform a linear regression analysis in R.
I have already installed R, Visual Studio Code. An R extension for Visual Studio Code. In the paper entitled A Study of the Relations of the Brain to the Size of the Head by Gladstone, published in Biometrika in 1905, he used outside measurements of the head to predict the approximate weight of the brain. The salient feature of this paper is that you would find the whole dataset in the appendix. I have created a CSV file based on the information gathered more than a century ago, and I want to use it in this demo. I want to open the Documents folder as my current workspace. And also, I need to open the integrated terminal and run R. Let's import the data into the R. Every variable is in a correct format, except the last three columns. So I want to convert gender, age group, and category to the factor data type. Okay, let's invoke the data viewer. As the summary shows, the average age is about 41 years. The average stature is around 63 inches. The next three variables provide information about height, length, and breadth of the head in millimeters. The head size is obtained from the product of these three variables and expressed in cubic centimeters. The brain weight is in grams with an average of 1264. The head circumference in millimeters. The next variable is the cephalic index. I excluded the cause of death from the summary. There are 159 males and 117 females. 39 of the subjects are under 20. 110 are between 20 to 46, and 127 are above 46. Depending upon the circumstances of the death, I categorized each subject in one of the general categories. Next, I want to compute the central tendency and dispersion measures for the brain weight grouped by gender and age group. Because of the high variance in the first age group, I want to exclude the rows containing data for the age group below 20. In this dataset, there are 57 males and 53 females between the age of 20 to 46, and 77 males and 50 females beyond 46. There is a decrease in the average brain weight in passing from the younger to the older groups. Regarding the other measurements, I prefer to review them pictorially. Let's plot brain weight versus head measurements to discover the relationships between brain weight and these variables. I change the color of the points by the levels of gender and the shape of the points by the levels of age group. The brain weight, the dependent variable, is linearly associated with the head measurements, the independent variables. Males have larger heads than females and subsequently heavier brains. It seems that a decrease in head size and brain weight takes place after middle age. Now I want to generate a group of graphs to compare brain weight and head measurements within each gender grouped by age category. These graphs better portray the difference between young and middle-aged and male and female subjects. There are outliers in each group. For example, in the case of brain weight, I don't know who these subjects can be. Okay, let's proceed. Now I want to take a look at the brain weight histogram. This graph shows that brain weight is normally distributed. There is a strong correlation between brain weight and head measurements. However, as I mentioned before, head size is obtained from the product of the other three variables, and therefore, to prevent multicollinearity, I should use only head size in the model or use the other three explanatory variables and exclude head size. Now it's time to get down to brass tacks. I want to know the association between brain weight and age plus three head measurements as covariates and gender as a dummy variable. The result indicates that there is a statistically significant association between the changes in brain weight and the changes in age, three head measurements, and gender. The p-values for height, length, and breadth of the head are less than the significance level of 0.001. The p-value for age is less than the significance level of 0.01, and for gender is less than 0.05. The intercept is also statistically significant at the level of 0.001. Each additional year of age is associated with 1.18 grams decrease in brain weight while holding the other variables in the model constant. 1 millimeter increase in head height causes 8.2 grams, head length 5.2 grams, and head breadth 4.1 grams increase in brain weight, provided that the other variables remain constant. Males have heavier brain weight by approximately 23.5 grams, holding age and head measurements constant. The residual standard error is 70.09. 5 observations removed from dataset due to missing values, and the model's R-squared is 0.65. This means that 65% of the variance in brain weight is explained by this model. Let's take a look at diagnostic plots. The first graph shows there is no relationship between residuals and fitted values. The normal QQ plot shows that the residuals are approximately normally distributed. The scale location plot indicates the homoscedasticity, And as the leverage plot shows, there are no influential outliers. I have already created the R Markdown document. Let's load R Markdown package. By using render function, I want to convert the R Markdown document to a PDF document. And thanks for watching.